In this video, we will cover how to determine if your extrusion meets standard industry twist tolerances using the Aluminum Association's aluminum standards and data. The difference between twist, flatness, and straightness can be confusing, so let's take a moment to discuss the differences. Flatness describes the absence of curvature in a surface measured across an extrusion from side to side. Straightness, often called bow, describes the absence of curvature measured down the length of the extrusion. Twist is something quite different. Twist describes the rotation of an extrusion around an axis running through its length, like if you were twisting two ends of a piece of pasta to make the piece pictured here. This would be an extreme case of twist. Aluminum standards and data has multiple tables for twist tolerances that depends on the product form, such as extruded profiles or bar, or cold finish bar. Twist tables are read the same way as tables for flatness tolerances, as discussed in our video covering flatness. The main difference is that twist tables provide tolerances in degrees of angular rotation per foot of length within specific total limits. Let's walk through the reading of the standard twist tolerance for an extruded bar using table 11.7. We'll use this 1.5-inch square bar as an example. It's 12 foot long, 1.5 inches wide, and it's 6061-T6511 alloy temper. Reading across the table, we know this is a bar, and T6511 temper will be in the TX511 row. The specified width is 1.5 inches, which will put us in the middle row of the cell in the next column over. As we continue across the table, our minimum thickness will be 0.500 and over. And then we see that the allowable twist tolerance will be half of a degree multiplied by length of the product in feet. Twist tolerances do not increase indefinitely with length. The column at the far right of the table specifies the maximum twist limits for the total length of an extrusion. For this example, the maximum allowable twist would be 5 degrees. If you multiply a half degree per foot by 12 feet, you will get 6 degrees. However, this is larger than the maximum for a total length, so the 5 degrees maximum will apply. There are important footnotes for table 11.7, especially footnote 6, that includes a table to help convert degrees to inches, and what to do if the profile contains both twist and bow. An easy way to convert degrees to inches is simply by multiplying degrees by 0.01745, which is the sine of 1 degree. To find the maximum allowable twist over the entire profile, you will multiply 5 degrees times 0.01745 to get 0.08725. Then multiply that times the 1.5-inch width, which equals 0.130875. To measure twist, you start by placing the profile on a flat surface. Hold one end down so the end is flat on the granite table, and use a feeler or taper gauge to measure the maximum gap between the profile surface. You can also use a digital protractor for this measurement by placing the protractor on one end, zeroing, and then place the protractor on the opposite end of the profile to determine the degrees of twist. You can see from the protractor that the degrees of twist is 2.8, which is below the 5-degree tolerance for the full profile. We will also need to check the tolerance on a per-foot basis, where the twist condition is most visible, to make sure the localized twist condition meets the allowable tolerance as well. On our 12-foot bar, the twist condition is most visible at a 4-foot span near the end. We'll take the same equation from table 11.7 we used earlier. A half degree multiplied by measured length, in this case a half degree times 4 foot, which will give us a tolerance of 2 degrees. You can convert degrees to inches by multiplying 2 degrees by 0.01745 by 1.5 inches width and get 0.052 inches allowable gap due to twist over a 4 foot distance. As we saw earlier in the video, the gap measures 0.065, which exceeds the allowable tolerance of 0.052 on a per foot basis. This profile is therefore considered not within tolerance. A profile must be within tolerance both on a per foot basis and over the entire profile. Since this profile is only within tolerance over the entire length, and not on a per foot basis where the twist condition is most visible, it is not considered within tolerance. Separately, if your profile or bar happens to contain bow and twist, you will need to measure for both. Measuring bow is covered in our video on straightness tolerances. Once you have measured both, you will need to subtract the bow from the twist measurement to get just the twist measurement. This is covered in footnote 6. There are important footnotes for each table that may or may not apply to your extrusion, depending on the geometry of the profile or certain alloy temper conditions. Get your copy of Aluminum Standards and Data, which contains the tables covered in this video, from the Aluminum Association's bookstore. It's available in US or metric units. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and engage with us on social media. Thanks for watching.